Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to another episode of our Project Zomboid playthrough. Okay, so I've organized all my stuff a bit more, and we're gonna get some breakfast here, eat some beef jerky to kick off our day. There we go. Yeah, we need some more food actually on us, so let's find some crisps. There we go, put those in there. Okay, so what are we gonna do today? We're gonna work on our defenses a bit more. So we need to head outside. Excuse the washing machine. I'm basically recording all these in a massive chunk. That's why the washing machine's been a constant part of these videos this week. So we need to get over to our woodpile. Start ferrying over some logs to where we need them. First of all, we take you out though. This axe probably doesn't have much left in it, but thank you for the spare. Talk about timing. Really couldn't get any better than that. Alright, so we are going to grab as many logs as we can carry. We're going to take them back to our base. We're going to chop them up into planks. And then we're going to start walling off areas of our base. So let's get this done. Let's pick up some more here. Probably take one in there or two in there. I'm not sure actually. Just the one. Should be able to get two in here though. Wow, that's loud. Okay, so we've got some logs. We're going to take these back to base. We're going to chop them up and then we're going to start building walls. Before we do that though, I should have read my next carpentry book. That's what I should have done. So we might do a bit of that. Although that's not going to be too interesting, is it? Let's take the saw. We can't take the saw because we don't have room for it. Alright, well, get off. Get off? That's not right. Get off. Let's dump the logs down here. Okay, we can't put them there because floor tiles have a weight limit. Or an amount you can actually put down. So let's find our carpentry book, which will be carpentry for intermediates. Ah, we've got two of them. Okay, makes sense. So let's hit read, and I guess we're going to fast forward time a bit here. How come it's only showing zero number of pages? Because that's cooking for intermediates. Good one, Ecky. Good one. That's the book you wanted. Carpentry, please. Thank you. What a waste of time. So, let's start reading that and hit fast forward just so we can get through this a bit quicker. Normally, I would do this off camera. Speed up, please. There we go. So, what are we going to talk about? Well, I have been catching up on The Walking Dead, finally. We're starting to watch Season 4. What are we on now? Season 5 of Walking Dead? I've seen a bit of Season 4. I saw the governor... spoilers in case you haven't seen it. But we saw the episodes where the governor attacks the prison and they've got a hightail out there. But we hadn't seen the episodes before that. So, starting to catch back up on The Walking Dead. Man alive, are they just the worst group to ever be stuck around in a zombie apocalypse? I cannot understand why. Like, they're surrounded by trees. They've got obviously got tools for chopping stuff up. Why they haven't secured all those fences by now with support props, I don't know. Especially when they've seen multiple times zombies pull up at certain areas and almost knock the fence down. You'd think sort of like prime thing you should do would be to like support all those fences. Dig some pits, put some punji sticks up or something. Maybe not do your farming and keep livestock in plain view of the zombies as well. I don't know, just so many bad choices being made by that group. It's unbelievable. And a friend of ours was saying last night, they should be doing daily bite checks as well. Why any group in a zombie apocalypse would not be checking that stuff, I don't know. But anyway, that's enough of that. We've almost finished reading our book, so we're going to get straight into some carpentry soon, although we are going to have to eat something and probably get some sleep before we do that. But we're getting close. It doesn't take too long to read a carpentry book as long as you've got the time sped up. But big apologies for this. Normally I would do this off camera and then start recording, but I just forgot to do it for this episode. Character is getting bored, not surprised. I imagine some of you are as well. But we're almost done now, 240 of 260, we will get there. We're going to grab something to eat out of the fridge, and then we'll probably get some sleep. It's basically taken us all day to read that book. But it was worth doing it, so we're going to put red books up on this shelf so we know what we have and haven't read. Let's grab something to eat. Did I see? Oh, it's a dead zombie. We're good. Let's eat some bell peppers. Why not? We should probably start looking into cooking some of this food up, even if it's just to make some salads, so maybe we'll do that. But first of all, let's get to sleep. And then we will chop some logs down and start building our lobby area. Still haven't decided whether we're just going to expand the warehouse or build a new place. But either way, we need to level carpentry up a bit before we do. If we're going to build our own place, I'd like better walls. So I think it's probably worth leveling it up a bit here. Let's grab our hammer. Let's grab our saw. Put some planks in our inventory. We're going to need more. Actually, let's just leave that. We'll grab a couple of boxes of nails. I'm sure we've got more than that. There we go. 3 boxes of nails. We'll take those. Alright. So, do we have our saw? Yes, we do. Put some more planks in our inventory. Why am I putting them in there? Put them in there. Makes much more sense. And also 1 box of nails. Now that was a crazy sound. That was almost like the guy's hungry or something. As am I, actually. I'm going to have to get some food pretty soon. Let's speed this process up a bit. There we go. Okay, so what do we want to do? Do we want to fence off this entire area? I guess we could do. What would we do with this space, though? Well, let's just start doing it. Nails, of course. Open the box of nails. And there we go. We've got 100 nails now. So, now we can start building wooden walls. So, we just right-click, select wall, click wooden wall, and if we press R, we can rotate the wall as well. Pick where you want it to go, left click to place it. Easy as that. Just make sure you've got a hammer and nails and planks in your inventory, and there you go. You can start building. So, we need some more logs here. Let's grab as many as we can carry. Let's speed time up slightly. Now we are going to get carpentry experience just from sawing the logs, which is extremely good. Helps you level up things a bit quicker. And especially more so having the skill books, because as you can see, there goes my dog. We have a multiplier of 5 on our carpentry level. We also get regular XP from sawing logs up, so it's a great way. It goes hand in hand with doing carpentry, basically. So, we need to keep building this wall a bit. Now, the only thing is, chances are we're probably going to replace some of these walls. Because they're not exactly great. And actually, we should just make ourselves a lobby area around here as well. So, we are going to start building that right there. There we go. And another one. And there we go, we've just got to level up. Let's have a look, see if we can put a point in. Now we still need to level up more carpentry. So we'll grab some more logs. It's a slow process, and what I will do in future is I'm probably going to... No. I'm probably going to just start ferrying logs and chopping them off camera, because that way we can get more done. We had the infamous 3 episodes in the multiplayer series where basically I spent the entire 3 episodes just placing walls down. So ideally we don't really want to repeat that. Wooden wall. So we place that there. And then we also want to create a door frame, and we'll place that right there. Now that's going to enable us to place a door down, which we will build soon enough. And rotate that. We don't have enough stuff anymore. Do we have enough to build a wooden pillar? Yes, we do. Now wooden pillars just slot in like so on the corners of your buildings. Now sometimes, it doesn't always happen, oops, but sometimes you used to be able to walk through the corner of a wall. So if you put a pillar down, that can't happen anymore. We're going to need some more logs, so let's head up here, grab some more. And again, this season we're going to try and mix things up. We're not going to spend multiple episodes in a row doing carpentry because it's not the most interesting of things to do, but we are going to rotate. So one episode we'll be doing carpentry, another episode we might do some farming, and then in another episode we'll probably do a loot run, and that way we can sort of mix up what we do, keep things interesting a bit. So that should all be good. Carpentry, boom, we've already got it. So it's kind of tempting to go and read another carpentry book, but we're not going to do that just now. We already did that, and I don't think we need to be reading more books. Plus, we're only going to be placing two more walls. It's not really too important to do that right now. We'll just lose a little bit of XP boost. Assuming we even have the carpentry book we need anyway. So we need some hinges and we need a doorknob so that we can create a door, and we probably have those in stock. So first of all, let's finish our walls off here. And there you go, you can see we've already got a much better class of wall, which sort of annoys me because now we've got these rubbish walls and I would rather have good walls. And marvelous, we've got that, that's in our way. You are in our way. Let's just dump down the planks right here. And we're going to grab our sledgehammer and hope that we can actually destroy that with a sledgehammer. I'm not sure if we can. There goes my dog having a bit of a scratch. Sledgehammer, sledgehammer, sledgehammer. Not in there. Sledgehammer. Now obviously, if you can, you've probably already can tell by now, but your items are sorted alphabetically, so it's easy to find your stuff. Although I often forget that. Okay, destroyed trash container. There we go. So we right click that and we take a sledgehammer to it. And like I said, it is super, super tempting to destroy these walls that I've built and replace them with good walls. So I'll probably do that off camera, actually. And there you go, you see we can actually do some building, get off, we can do some building just having the planks on the ground, which is pretty cool. So, we want to build a wooden pillar and we want to put it right there. Now, do we destroy this wooden wall? Not yet, I'll do it off camera. So, let's put the sledgehammer in there. We'll use this as our construction crate for now anyway. At some point we're going to destroy all of these crates. So we're looking for hinges and doorknobs. We have two hinges right there. So we'll take those. And we have one doorknob. Brilliant. So we're going to go and create a door. And there we go. We have a lobby system here now. Now, thing with this is, firstly, it's going to give us protection. Alright, we're going to need to pick... Stop doing that. We need to pick these planks up. It's going to give us a double layer of protection. If we get zombies here on the door, then they're going to have to get through two doors to get to us. So that is the first reason I do it. Now, the only thing that's bad about it is, if there are zombies gathered around here, this is our only means of escape. Right now, anyway. So it's not ideal, but hopefully we can do something about that. And alright, so let's just pause this for a while. Put this stuff away. Need some chips. Put those box of nails in there. I will transfer everything over to everything we need carpentry wise over there pretty soon. But for now, we grab that. So what I want to do is I want to head upstairs. I want to break down the door up there, and we're going to set up a farm up here. So this is a great spot for a farm. Come on. There we go. This door's generally locked. I'm not even going to check it. I'm just going to assume it is. We can use the sledgehammer to destroy all this stuff. So what we need is a spade. Which we don't have. I'm sure we've got a spade. Didn't I loot one? Spade, thank you. So we grab that. We grab one trowel. We got any cabbage seeds? No. Yes. Grab those. What else do I want to take? I want the empty sandbag. Don't we have a gravel bag as well? Gravel bag, gravel bag, gravel bag. Yes. So we'll take that. Okay, so now we head outside. Close that. Do that. And I guess we'll take dirt from over here. So we're going to spill gravel. And we're going to spill it right here. Why not? So this is emptying out the gravel bag. And there we go. Wow, that's a lot of gravel though. Seriously? Yeah, okay, that's done. So now we want to take some dirt in our empty sandbag. And you can see we equip our shovel to do that, and we leave a little patch of ungrassed area, and we want to fill up our empty sandbag. Okay. Re-equip our axe. Now, we want to head upstairs. Close that. Do that. Now, ideally, what we would do is we would set up some rain collector barrels up here so that we can obviously collect rain and use that to water our crops. So I guess let's just spill some dirt right here. Now, one thing to note about farming is it's possible for your crops to get sickly. So what you want to do is you want to space out all your crops like this with one gap between them. Come on. Okay, they're both empty. So now we want to dig, and this uses the trowel. As you can see, we've now equipped the trowel, and dig. And there we go, done. Now what we need to do is open our cabbage seeds, right click here, sow seed, sow cabbages, done, sow seed, sow cabbages, done. Next thing we want to do is equip our axe, primary, there we go. We could do with making a crate up here, so we'll probably do that in a later episode, or I'll do it off camera or something. But for now, let's just drop off both of these, this, not that, the worm, the trowel. Drop those off. Now, where is our watering can? Well, it's not in there, is it? Still moving stuff? No. Worms can be used as fishing bait, just so you know. I know I had a watering can. I know I did. Did I put it in here? Watering can. There we go. Put that in your main inventory. Take it to a water source. Well, we'll fill the water bottle up first, and then we'll fill our watering can. And this is why we create rain collectors upstairs, so we don't have to run down to a water source to do this. Let's get up here. Here we go. And now what you want to do is you want to give it the full amount of water that it can take. We just used our watering can, which sucks. There we go. Sorry, we used our water bottle, not our watering can, which sucks. So if we're clicking for well watered, health, they're still sickly at the moment. Diseases, no. So if they get diseased, it will spread to nearby plants, which is why we have the one gap between them. And eventually we will have this whole area, well, a lot of this area filled with crops. What I did wrong here is it's often wise to plant some cabbages on one day, water them, wait 2 or 3 days, plant your next lot, because otherwise both these cabbages are going to sprout at the same time. We're going to have tons of cabbages and they will just go rotten before we get a chance to eat them all. So it makes more sense to stagger your planting, basically, to rotate your crops, as it were. Alright, so we can drop that off now. We do need to fill up our water bottle again. Like so. And I'm not sure what time we started recording, but I think we've been going 20 minutes now, guys. So I'm going to call this the end of the episode here. As always, really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more Project Zomboid. Peace.